Okay, so we have reached our next milestone. In this what we have done is we have connected our front steering system, which is powered by a DC motor, to a DC motor controller, which we spoke about earlier. And what we have done is we have also connected the rear traction motor also to the same DC motor controller. Because this DC motor controller is capable of driving two motors from the same controller. So, because our car has two motors, so one controller is sufficient. And then we have connected the digital inputs of this controller to the digital pins on the Arduino Nano board. So, this board will now contain the logic to govern or control the car. So, if I were to talk more about wiring, so what we did was we have extended the wires which we cut. So we, for example, this wire was short, so we have extended with extra wires and use insulation. Similarly, this wire was also short, so we have added more wire to it so that we have plenty of length to move around things. And again, since our motor had three wires, the black wire has been used to connect to the ground to suppress all the electronic noises which are generated from the motor. And the brown and the blue wire are actually the positive and the negative wire of the motor. And if I reverse the polarity of voltage, the motor will rotate in other direction. So if, let's say, I give positive to the brown, it will rotate in one direction. And if I give negative, that is 0 volt, to brown, it will move in the other direction. And we have used a flat ribbon cable to connect this DC controller to the Arduino board. In addition to that, you can see at the bottom, we have used the original battery of the RC controller. This battery will be used only to power the DC motors of the vehicle. We will not use this power source to control the Arduino board. Right now we are testing it. So what will happen is that the Arduino board will be current now powered by a USB wire. But once the project is complete, we will deploy one more power source to basically power the whole thing. So now you can see my son has connected. So what we did was we programmed Arduino with a small program to test the functionality. What it does is that first it will power the rear motor and the front controller. Right now what it is doing, it is testing the speed. So what it does, it increases the speed. Now it is just doing front and back. So you can see the software is steering the vehicle. It is waiting for 5 seconds now. Now it will test the speed. So gradually it increases the speed. And here you can see gradually it is steering the vehicle also in small steps. And now it's a full throttle. See, you can see now it waits for 5 seconds. And now it will do gradual. So it's a small acceleration, gradual acceleration of the rear vehicle and gradual turn. So you can see, you notice that the turn is now very gradual. Again waits, now full. So this is the full speed control. And now it will happen in a slow speed. So right now the Arduino is powering the vehicle in a test mode. There's a small test code that we have written in this flash of memory of the Arduino board, just to validate our understanding and test the wiring. This basically completes our first milestone. The next milestone is to start wiring some extra electronics like LED bulbs and all in the hood. So we will put some fancy stuff in the hood, which will be again powered by the same Arduino, because it still has a lot of vacant ports. So we plan to use one LED, in fact two LEDs for headlights and four LEDs for front and back turn indicators. Once that wiring is done, then we will move to the subsequent milestone of connecting this Arduino with a Raspberry Pi, and then the Raspberry Pi will be connected to a onboard camera, and also we will deploy a collision detection using ultrasonic wave. So those are the next milestones to come. For now, our vehicle is able to move backward, forward, just like an RC controlled machine, however, with a digital controller.